Welcome dear students in part 3 of some basic concepts of chemistry. Let's have a look on chemical classification of matter. If you have not watched the part 2, that is physical classification of matter, then click on the above link to watch the same. Matter is classified into two categories, mixture and pure substance, on the basis whether composition is uniform throughout or not. Pure substance is that which contains only one kind of atoms or molecules. Just we are having water, carbon dioxide. These are pure substances because they are made up of only one kind of particles. Just we are having carbon dioxide. It consists of carbon and oxygen atoms in a fixed ratio. In mixture, elements or compounds are mixed together in any ratio, in any proportion. There is no any definite ratio in case of mixture. Just we are having air. Air is a mixture. Similarly, salt and sugar solutions, they are also mixtures. Just like seawater, it's a mixture of salts and water, and they are present in any proportion. There is no definite proportion in case of mixture. Now let's have a look on the types of pure substances. Pure substance can be an element or a compound. Element is that pure substance which is made up of only one kind of atoms. So just we are having 118 elements. Like we are having sodium, it's a metal. Copper, it is also a metal. Silver, it's also a metal. Hydrogen, it's a non-metal. Oxygen, a non-metal, and a gas. So an element cannot be further separated into its constituents by physical or chemical means. Just we are having oxygen as an element, so it cannot be separated into oxygen atoms by any physical means. Now in case of compound, two or more elements combine chemically in a fixed proportion or fixed ratio by mass. Just we are having ammonia, it's a compound. Water, it's also a compound. Glucose, it's also a compound. So let's, if we take water as a compound, here the two elements hydrogen and oxygen, they are present in a fixed ratio. Just if we see in case of water, hydrogen and oxygen cannot be separated by physical means, but they can be separated by chemical means like electrolysis. So with the help of electrolysis, we can get the two gases, hydrogen and oxygen, from water. Now in case of compound, properties are totally different from those of its constituents. Just hydrogen is it's a gas and combustible. Oxygen is a support of combustion, also a gas, but water is a liquid and it is neither combustible nor supporter of combustion. Instead, water is used as a fire extinguisher. Now mixture can be further classified into two categories on the basis that whether particles are uniform throughout or not. So a mixture can be homogeneous or it can be heterogeneous. A homogeneous mixture is that which has uniform composition and properties throughout, just like sugar solution. Here you will find properties same everywhere. Now in case of heterogeneous mixture, properties are different throughout and composition is also different. Just we are having starch solution, milk, blood, all these are heterogeneous mixtures because their composition is different. Now a mixture can be separated into its constituents by physical methods. Just if we are having the particles of iron, and similarly the dust particles or pebbles, stones, and if we are having a magnet, magnet will easily separate iron particles from the mixture. Thank you for watching.